Hi, I'm Victor Cohen. This is the MCAT for Victory Anki course, and today we're going to talk about what your Anki settings should look like while studying for the MCAT. Anki is best used for long-term studying to keep the material fresh in your mind. That means that those who study for longer will benefit the most. Still, everyone who uses Anki to study will be in a better position due to the advantages of active recall and spaced repetition.
To get to the settings, click the gear icon next to the deck, then click Options. Now click Manage and select Add. Label the group name MCAT for Victory. The first screen is the setting for the new cards. After seeing a new card for the first time, it will become a card you are learning. The steps represent the intervals for new cards that are in the learning phase. The first number represents the interval for seeing the card after pressing again, while the second number represents the interval for seeing the card after pressing good. The steps are represented in minutes and are separated by a space between the numbers. I recommend making the first number 5 and the second number 30. This means you will see the card again in 5 minutes after pressing again. If you then press good, you will see the card again in 30 minutes. Pressing good on a card twice in a row will graduate the card and relabel it as young. Next, select Show New Cards in Order Added. This will mean you will see the cards in an organized fashion that follows the videos. The cards were created for the information to build upon itself, meaning it is best to see the card in the order they were created. Now comes the difficult part, selecting how many new cards you want to see per day.
This number will be different for everyone, because there are many factors that influence the maximum number of new cards that you will do in a day. One way to make this calculation is to find out how many days there are between the day that you will begin Anki and your MCAT test day. Then, divide all the cards evenly. For example, if you are studying for 10 weeks, you would have 70 days before your test. Dividing 3,800 cards by 70 days would give you 55 cards per day to finish the entire deck. However, most students start with a schedule filled with content review, then transition to practice questions and practice exams. That means most of your new cards will be learned in the first 5 to 6 weeks of studying. You should always attempt to finish all the new cards related to the videos you watch, but be careful not to overwhelm yourself with too many new cards. Doing too many new cards will result in a pileup of reviews that may be overwhelming.
Therefore, I recommend setting the maximum new cards per day to 100 at most. Doing more than 100 new cards per day will be too stressful for the majority of students, so please feel free to make this number lower if needed. Many students enjoy doing around 50 new cards per day. Do not worry about changing the graduating interval, which is when the card goes from learning to young. Also, do not worry about the easy interval, which represents when you will see a new card again if you select easy. The starting ease should be 250%, and you should select the box where related new cards are buried till the next day. This prevents you from seeing notes with multiple closed deletions all on the same day. Instead, Anki will distribute the closed deletions over separate days. Nothing else needs to be changed on this page, so it is time to transition to the review settings. First, the maximum reviews per day should be set to the maximum number, so type as many 9s as you can. You should finish all your reviews every single day. I recommend setting the easy bonus to 150%. Selecting easy would mean the interval will be multiplied by the ease factor, and they will both be multiplied by the easy bonus. For example, selecting easy on a card with an interval of 10 days and an ease factor of 250% would mean you will see the card again in 38 days, 10 times 2.5 times 1.5. The interval modifier is good at 100%. This is an additional multiplication for when you will see the cards again. If you are getting too many cards wrong, decrease the interval modifier by a bit to see cards more often. If you are getting too many cards right or easy, increase the interval modifier by a bit to see cards less often. Last on this page is the maximum interval.
This is the maximum number of time that can elapse before you are shown the card again. This means that if your maximum interval is 180 days and you select easy on a card with a 180 day interval, Anki will still show you that card again in 180 days. Some like to have short maximum intervals, like 50 days, to see cards very often, while others like to have no maximum interval and trust the Anki algorithm. While there are many who believe that this should be somewhere in the middle, I lean closer to the second group, where I trust the Anki algorithm to show me the flashcard right before I'm about to forget it. This means I do not set a maximum interval. With such a limited amount of time before the MCAT, it is very important to spend your time efficiently. Overly reviewing flashcards is not a good use of time. Your time could be better spent doing questions, relaxing, or sleeping.
That means I recommend writing a bunch of nines here. Feel free to play around with this setting if you want to see the cards more often. Just like for the news, I recommend selecting the option to bury related cards until the next day to prevent seeing related closed deletions back to back. Now, it is time to move on to lapses, which are the reviews you get wrong. The steps represent when you will see these reviews again. I recommend setting this to 45 minutes.
It would be awful to have to start each card from scratch just from getting it wrong once. So that is where the new interval comes in. This represents what happens to the interval after getting a young or mature card wrong.
I recommend setting this to 20%, meaning that a card will keep 20% of its interval after you get it wrong. The minimum interval is good at 1. This represents the lowest interval a card can have before being considered young. Next, the leech threshold should be 6, and you should select tag only. This means cards will be tagged as leeches after you get it wrong 6 times. Leeches are cards that need to be fixed. The leeches may be poorly written, or you may be confusing the card with a similar concept. Regardless, a card labeled as a leech means you are facing difficulty with that information, and you should figure out how to fix that. Now we move on to general. Here, I recommend setting ignore answer times longer than 18 seconds. Anki statistics will tell you how long you studied every day.
This means if you get distracted while studying and leave Anki open for a flashcard, Anki will not consider any time after 18 seconds to contribute to your study time. If you had set this time to 1 hour and then you happened to walk away your keyboard while a flashcard was left open, Anki will say you studied that one flashcard for 1 hour.
The automatically play alert after option will try to bring your attention to the length of time you have spent reviewing a card. I recommend making this 0 to turn this feature off. Then make automatically show answer after 15 seconds, which means you will have 15 seconds to think of the answer to each card. It should hopefully take you around 10 seconds to answer each flashcard on average. So making the flashcards automatically flip to the answer after 15 seconds should be enough time for you to think of the answer. This will help improve your efficiency to ensure you get through Anki as quickly as possible. Lastly, put automatically rate again after 0 seconds to turn this feature off. If you get a card wrong, I recommend you take your time to truly understand why you got the card wrong. There is no need to rush after getting a card wrong. Lastly, I personally like to see the answer timer, and the sound options are not important for the MCAT for Victory deck. Click OK to save your settings. Now, you should make sure every subdeck has the settings set properly. Click on the gear icon, then select Options for each subdeck, and ensure that the MCAT for Victory settings are selected. While those are the deck-specific settings, there are more settings in Anki that need to be changed. To get to these additional settings, click Anki on the toolbar and select Preferences. Under Basic, you can find audio and copy/paste information as well as options to enable night mode. I recommend selecting when adding default to the current deck. Then go to scheduling, where you will want to enable show the next review time above answer button, and enable show remaining card count during review. It is very important to select show new cards after reviews. This will ensure you only do new cards after finishing all your reviews. Your priority should always be to finish your reviews. That means doing new cards can wait if you are overwhelmed with the quantity of cards you currently have due. Next, make the next day start at 5 a.m. to make the late night studying count towards the previous day. The learn ahead limit allows you to study ahead of time by a few minutes, which can be useful to finish your incorrect reviews when you do not have the time to wait. I generally recommend setting this to 0. I'm now going to quickly go through network, backups, load balancer, and life drain. You may want to make sure your settings look the same. When you are done, press close.
And that's where I'm going to end this episode. In this video, we covered Anki settings. Next episode, we will go over how to use the Anki browser.